Let's talk about the bottom-up approach, how we get the most out of our trading journal, and we're also going to see our first challenge that we are tackling now. So there are two very important journaling principles. First, we have to focus on what matters. We don't want to get lost in the nitty-gritty, and we don't want to waste our time trying to fix everything at once or focusing on the wrong things. And second, we want to always identify the biggest performance leaks. So we want to find the area in our trading that is costing us the most, because if we can fix that, it's going to have a big impact on our bottom line. When you're just getting started with journaling, it's like establishing a new habit. It will take some time, but the time that you spend with your trading journal, getting familiar with Edgewonk and putting in the data, it's going to be worthwhile, because the results that you're getting are based on your own personal trading data, and it will help you to adjust your trading approach to improve your trading. So first, it's important that you establish a routine for your journal. Ideally, you journal your trades when the memory is still fresh. We recommend to journal the trades at the end of the trading day. This is especially important for day traders who might have multiple trades a week. If you're more of a longer-term trader, journaling your trades by the end of the week might also be okay. But it's important that you find a specific time of the day or at the week that you set aside for your journaling routine so that it becomes a habit and you don't forget about it. Also, you don't want to overwhelm yourself and you really want to focus on the basics. I talked about this in the previous videos where I highlighted the importance of making sure the data is correct, making sure you have your stop loss and take profit journaled if that's part of your trading, and also focusing on the comments, which we're going to dive in this video. But beyond that, especially in the beginning, you should not spend more time on getting all the little details and data points about your trades. There's obviously so much that you can track in Edgewonk, but especially in the beginning, you just want to get in the basics because they are going to help you the most and it helps you also save time. Point number three, and this is very important, the more time you invest with your trading journal and the more time you invest with tracking data, the more helpful the data will be in the end and the results will also be more significant. So don't see it as a waste of time, don't see it as a chore that you have to do, but see it as an investment into your trading. And four, don't forget that results won't happen overnight, but it also won't take very long to see the benefits of journaling. So when we talk about finding the biggest performance leaks and finding the areas where traders have the most potential for improvement, we were able to identify three common areas. First, it's breaking trading rules. That can be taking random trades, jumping into trades too early, breaking your trading rules, chasing the price, revenge trading, and any other inconsistencies in your trading approach. That's usually the biggest thing that traders have to tackle first, and that's also what we're going to focus on later in this video. But if you can fix that, usually you should see a huge improvement in your trading. The second biggest problem area is mismanaging trades, and that refers to making bad in-trade decisions, so once a trade is on. And that means usually letting losses run too long while cutting winning trades too early. A lot of traders are struggling with that. And three, it's taking too much risk. So you take positions that are way too big for your actual account size. It can be inconsistencies in your position sizing and overall over-leveraging. And now we're going to focus a little bit more on breaking trading rules, because that's usually the first thing that traders must fix. And here we talk about a better execution. And the most important thing to improve in the beginning is adherence to your trading rules. Because one, if you cannot follow your trading rules, no matter how good the system that you have is, it will not be profitable. You can have the best tested trading rules, but if you cannot follow them, then obviously it's not going to help. Second, we want to focus on trade execution and we want to make sure that we follow our trading plans and trading rules. Because number three, a disciplined trader is always a better trader. And that brings us to our first challenge. We want to use the Tiltmeter and we want to remember that we want to keep the Tiltmeter green at all times. Because once we start focusing on making the best trades possible, the results usually follow. So we're back in Edgewonk now, and we want to focus on the Tiltmeter, which is here in your Edgewonk trading journal. And the journal is, it's a column here. You can also drag it to the front if you want to see it more prominently. And here we have an open trade. It has a white background, so it means it's open. Let's open this up. We go to advanced trade data, and here we have our entry, exit, and trade management comments. Those are the comments that we can assign to our trades. They should describe the action that you have taken on the specific trade. We have already created some entry comments. Again, I will show you a few suggestions for entry comments in a moment. But when we open this dropdown, you can see we have some that are colored in red and there's one colored in green. Green describes the perfect entry, and then red refers to common issues and problems that traders face with their entry. So let's assign a red comment for the entry, save the trade, and let's see what happens. This makes the tilt meter go red. It's just a little bit red, but it's still indicating that something went wrong here. So let's open the trade again, go back to advanced trade data, and now let's go to exit comment. So here we have a few comments as well. We have one green one, we have two black ones, which describe a neutral action, so that's neither good or bad. And then we have also some red comments, which indicate a negative trading behavior. So let's assign another negative comment to this trade, and let's take a look at the trade management. Same principles apply here. Green refers to a good and positive behavior. The black comment is a neutral behavior. And then red refers to a negative trading behavior where you've broken your rules. So let's assign another red one and let's see what happens. The tilt meter is now full size. It is completely red. So we have three negative trade comments assigned to this trade, which means that the tilt meter is fully red. When you scroll through the journal, you can see that the tilt meters have different lengths. So it depends on how many positive or negative comments you have assigned to your trade. Let's go to the comments so I can give you some ideas on what to write for your trade management entry and exit comments. You can pause the video and see if they make sense to you. Use it as an inspiration and see if you can apply them to your trading as well, if they make sense for your type of trading. As I mentioned in the previous video, try to use fewer comments. You don't want to have lists with 10 or 20 comments because it's not going to lead to a lot of helpful data because you're not going to use each individual comment a lot. What we can also do is go to the chart lab, and here we have a chart that is called trade comments. So you can see here at the second dropdown, we have trade entry comments selected, and that brings us all the entry comments that we have used in the journal. And you can see when we assign the comment perfect entry, which is positive, we have the best performance. When we're taking entries that are too late or impulsive or too early, the performance is negative. And that's a very good indication of how specific trade actions and behaviors influencing your trading performance. You can switch between the trade exit and also trade management to visualize the performance when specific comments have been assigned. Another helpful graph here under chart lab is the efficiency. The efficiency refers to how well in percentage terms you are able to stick to your rules. So let's take a look at this data point. This shows us that we have 59%. This means that in 59% of all our trading actions, we are efficient. We are able to stick to our trading rules. The higher the efficiency, the better it is. The lower the efficiency, the more often you have broken your trading rules and the more negative comments you have assigned. So keep the tilt meter green. Make sure that your efficiency is trending higher. It's not really realistic to shoot for a 100% efficiency because it's quite normal and human to make mistakes every now and then, but strive for an increasing efficiency. Try to at least get your efficiency above 50%, which means that on most trading decisions, you're making good trading decisions. And what happens once traders start getting into the habit of keeping the tilt meter in mind, even when you are trading, during your trading, you will make better decisions. Because when you're about to take a trade, when you're about to exit or enter or manage a trade, you will keep your tilt meter in mind. You will always ask yourself, how is this going to affect my tilt meter? Is this going to make my tilt meter green? Is it going to give me a red tilt meter? And keep the challenge in mind. You always want to keep your tilt meter green at all times. The more green you see in your tilt meter, the better it is for your overall trading. We even have a little gamification built into Edgewonk. So when we go here to the top right and then we open milestones, you will see a few milestones. And the second milestone is called the disciplined trader. As you can see, it reads here, can you reach 50 green tilt meter trades? Prove your consistency. And we have achieved the bronze level, so we're going to level up here shortly. And this is a great way of gamifying your trading journal and your trading behavior. Try to advance and rank up through the different levels here for the disciplined trader. And don't forget, always keep the tilt meter green.